know, for me, as I've gotten older, I realize that happiness and success, they're not synonymous. They don't mean the same thing, but they're very directly correlated. And for me, a big portion of my definition of success is the happiness and fulfillment that I have. So what I would say, if you're really passionate about something, but you're not very good at it, it doesn't mean you need to give up on it. It might not be your prime vocation, but it could still be a hobby. It could still be something that you do during the unseen hours because you enjoy it so much. Now, if you're really talented at something, but you can't stand doing it, I just don't think that's sustainable. I think that's something that people call the grind, which, as you know, I'm opposed to, which is, I'm just doing this because I'm good at it, but boy, I don't enjoy it. And for me, that's just kind of a hollow way to go through life. I don't want to go through life doing things that I don't enjoy. Now, I am a realist. I'm not implying that every moment of every day of my life is not puppy dogs and ice cream. But the vast majority of what I get an opportunity to do are things that fill my bucket and I love to do. And my goal is to design a life where I'm doing most of those things most of the time. And so I think when we look at those four quadrants, we should all be working feverishly to stay in that quadrant of what we love and what we're good at. And for some people, you can find a dream job where you work for someone else and you're in that sweet spot, and that's awesome. Other people, that's what leads them to being freelancers and entrepreneurs, is they want to have control over being in their strength zone. So they just go out and start their own thing. And that's another path as well. But I firmly believe, to be the best version of yourself and to live the happiest and most fulfilling life you can, you need to spend as much time in that quadrant as possible. I was a decent player in Montgomery County, Maryland. You know, I wasn't an all-state player. I certainly wasn't an all-American. I was a decent player, played at a very small school down in North Carolina, Elon, but had a mediocre, and that would be generous, career at Elon, which I'm not diminishing that. Just the fact that I played college basketball does put me in kind of an upper tier, but was very mediocre by college basketball standards. And yet you can see the wall behind me. I've had an opportunity to work with Kobe Bryant and LeBron James and Stephen Curry and Kevin Durant. So even though I was not an exceptional player by any stretch, I've had an opportunity to do what I love with people that are the absolute best of all time. So yeah, let's make sure that we're not limiting ourselves and limiting our future with what we can do based on where we are at the present. And I love you bringing up the concept of role player, because I do believe one of the most coveted skills in the world right now, aside from leadership and good communication, is someone that is a great teammate. Someone that understands that they might not be the best on the team, but they can be the best for the team, and that they have the selflessness to say, I'm going to do everything I can to make those around me better and to make our team better. And that is really hard to find, those types of people. So I can certainly attest that you are the consummate role player. But I think anyone that has that mindset, you're going to have a very, very bright future if you embrace it instead of trying to resist it.